Hello and welcome to Delirium Plus. I'm Ghosthead, and in this video, I'll be working on this piece of splash art for my game, Project Bounty. Splash art is the art that is created to be seen on the splash screen. While you wait for your game to load, you see this art in other places too, like a character select screen, for example. I'll be sharing 10 tips on how to do splash art for your game. There are probably hundreds of great tips out there, but these are the ones I use the most. Let's start off with one that I don't always follow. Try a bunch of different comps for your piece. A lot of times I'll have an idea stuck in my head, so I won't try more compositions. But spending a bit more time on thumbnails might surprise you. Using a different composition than what you originally planned might actually improve it a lot. For the second tip on splash art for your game, don't be afraid to be a little messy. You can always erase it, draw over it, redo it. It's kind of the point of doing roughs. You're not committed to the piece yet. Tip number 3, quick strokes. Probably a tip you'll hear most from artists. Become very friendly with the undo hotkey. If you haven't yet, I would bind that to a key. Drawing with your arm is one way of helping your strokes. When I mean drawing with your arm, I'm talking about not moving your fingers or your wrists. Also, figure out what direction is best for your making your strokes. You could always rotate your canvas if needed. If you're still struggling, tip number 4 will help you. After struggling with tip number 3, or deciding you want to try a different method, there's the pen tool. The pen tool can be a lifesaver for any artist. With the pen tool, you can make a stroke as long as you want. And an extra thing I like to do is erase the tips so it gives it more weight. Tip number 5, making a clip mask layer for your flats. I use Photoshop, but I'm sure whatever software you use has something equivalent to clip mask. With the clip mask, I don't feel worried about going out of my space that I want to use. Depending on the piece, I'll split up the layers into different colors, which helps with my next tip. Now for the 6th tip, using gradients on your flats. Giving flats a minor gradient can give it a little extra that you didn't know you needed. Picking two colors with slight different hues and saturations can really make a piece. At least I think so. Tip number 7 is a must. Don't use black for your tones. Unless you're going for a straight black and white or a sterile white light, don't use black for your shadows. What you should do is use a complementary color to your light source. Saturated warm light, like a yellow-orange, then use a desaturated dark bluish violet. This tip will add much more to your piece. The 8th tip for making splash art, rim lights. Sometimes known as hair lights or halo lights, rim lights are great to highlight shapes and contour. You could also use it to separate your subject from the background. If you're looking to add a little layer of drama or mystery, it also helps. Number 9, blur effect. Sounds very simple, because it is. I like making a copy of my piece, giving it a bit of blur, and reducing the opacity. Sometimes if I want to really focus on an area and keep a crisp look to it, I'll erase the blur layer on the spots I want. Also, blurring some areas to emphasize motion can look pretty good. The 10th and final tip of the video, the color dodge tool. If you aren't familiar with what it does, it brightens the base color with the blend color. It's great for making your piece pop. I'm going to throw in an extra tip for you all. Sleep. Being serious, rest is very important. A lot of the time, simple mistakes happen because of lack of sleep. Like how I had to go back and fix Yuki's helmet. Thank you all for sticking around till the end of the video. Now I want you all to stay lively and see you later.